still going on at the airport. So, leaving Aruba, why did I think it's going? Yep, that's our plane.
That's cool to see it.
Yes, it is cool.
You can follow along with the safety information card in your seatback pocket. Federal aviation regulation requires your flight to go through member instructions, lighted information signs, and posted placards. To fasten your seatbelt, insert the flat metal end into the buckle, pull on the strap to tighten. To release, just lift the top flap of the buckles. Please keep your seatbelts fastened low and tight across your lap, even when the seatbelt sign is off, and have your seatbelt visible to the crew at all times. Your life vest is in a pouch underneath your seat. If instructed by the crew, tear open the pouch, remove the vest and pull it over your head. Wrap the strap around your waist, secure the buckle and pull the strap to tighten. As you exit the aircraft, inflate the vest by pulling down firmly on the vest tabs or blowing into the tubes on both sides. A locator light on your shoulder will turn on automatically in water, never inflate your vest inside the aircraft. This Airbus A320 has 8 emergency exits, 2 doors in the front, 4 windows exits over the wings, 2 doors in the back. Each door is equipped with an evacuation slide that can be detached from the aircraft and used as a raft. An additional raft is located in the forward storage unit. In the event of an emergency, leave all personal belongings and proceed to the nearest exit. All exits are clearly marked with a sign overhead. If necessary, floor level lighting will illuminate the outside of your final exit. Moment now to locate your closest exit and remember it might be behind you. If there is a change in cabin pressure, for oxygen masks will drop from the overhead. Firmly pull the mask towards you to start the flow of oxygen. Remove any face covering. Place the oxygen mask over your nose and mouth. Pull the elastic band around your head and tighten using the straps on both sides. Even though the bag may not inflate, oxygen will be flowing. Please place yours first before helping others. We will let you know when it's no longer needed. If you have any doubts or questions about the safety features of the aircraft, please don't hesitate to ask. Smoking, including the use of electronic cigarettes, is never allowed on any JetBlue flight. Tampering with, disabling, or destroying smoke detectors in an aircraft restroom is a federal offense and could result in a fine. For your convenience, this aircraft has 3 restrooms, one in the front of the cabin and 2 in the back. One in the front and one in the back have infant changing tables. To avoid crowding in the aisle, please wait at your assigned seat until a restroom is available. We will be adjusting the main cabin lights for departure. If you need it, there is a reading light above your seat. We're here to make sure you have a safe, comfortable flight. Thank you for your attention. We hope you enjoy the flight with us.
flight deck. It looks like we're number one for takeoff. We'll be aboard shortly. In flight, please be seated.
Yeah.
didn't.
JetBlue would like to welcome you to Boston, where the local time is 7:27 p.m. For your safety, please continue to have your seatbelts fastened and carry-on items put away until the captain has turned off that seatbelt sign. Be careful when opening those overhead vents as items tend to move during flight. If you ever receive this, as claim at gate. You may pick up those items at the boarding door. If you need any assistance getting off the plane, feel free to remain seated after we have arrived at gate so we may better assist you. For information on connecting flights or baggage claim, you may check airport monitors or download our free JetBlue mobile app. Be sure to visit JetBlue.com to learn about our TrueBlue loyalty program, where you can earn points on all of your flights starting with today's flight. On behalf of all of us here at JetBlue, especially this New York City-based crew, we'd like to thank you for flying with us today. You have a wonderful evening.
Huh? Oh, I thought you said something. Okay, so I just want to start out that I unfortunately did not do the outro of this video because that's what I normally do, but lots of craziness happened. And not only that, I was tired. So, like I said earlier in the video, our flight was delayed. Well, I wrote it in the description in this video. So, we decided to go to the airport anyway, just for, you know, the heck of it. Because you want to be on time. You don't want to miss your flight and all this stuff. So when we got back to Boston, we went to the luggage claim, or baggage claim actually, sorry, to get our luggages. So now, once we got our luggages, we went back to, well, we went on the bus and all that stuff, but we were heading back to Woburn because that's where we parked our car and all that stuff. Now, when we were getting our luggages, my luggage went missing, and my dad thought it was my backpack, because he says that was it. But my backpack had my laptop, my chargers, like my phone charger, my laptop charger, and GoPro, and all that stuff. So he thought that was it, but it was my clothes that was missing, not my expensive stuff, which is fortunate, though, that wasn't it. So, but, you know, and then that's when we did find out that it was my clothes that was missing. All my luggage was missing. So that was unfortunate. So my mom had to call the airport, and then she also had to call the Massachusetts State Police. So we talked to an officer and all this stuff, and he told us that if a luggage was left unattended, the police would be the ones who would take it. And they probably had to search it because due to, you know, security reasons, you know, they thought that maybe it could be a bomb inside and all that stuff. So obviously don't have any of that stuff. So I don't care what they did with it. I just want to make sure it's there and all that stuff. So he told us that what we need to do is that we need to file a missing luggage, but we won't do it until the next day. So, and like I said, I was really tired and I forgot to do it. And that was kind of like bothering me during that time. So I didn't do it. So I'm sorry that I didn't do it, but I figured I'll do it anyway for the voiceover, just for the heck of it. So, but I mean, I know it was fortunate. It was just my clothes and all the stuff, not my laptop and stuff. So, but you know, but anyway, the good news is they were able to find my luggage. So that was until Tuesday that we had the report. And they didn't bring it up here for Thursday. We had a UPS driver to bring it. So, yeah. So that was unfortunate for me that my luggage went missing, including my toothbrush. Well, that was the only thing that was there. But at least it wasn't really expensive, like I said earlier. At least it wasn't my laptop. Because that's why I didn't want to bring that in the baggage claim and all this stuff. I just wanted to carry it on with me, so that way that it's with me this whole time. So, you know. But anyway, I hope you enjoyed those videos to Aruba, or our trip to Aruba. You know, it was really fun and enjoyable. So, yeah. All right, guys. Don't forget to subscribe. Hit that notification bell button so you don't miss any of my videos. And I'll see you guys next time. Bye-bye.